What's going on, guys? My name is Mark Wagner, and today we're going to be talking about how you can dropship the right way the rest of 2019 and going into 2020. Now, everyone knows that dropshipping is changing a lot, and in this video, I'm going to show you the exact process that I'm taking and that I think you should take in order to come out on top. Let's go ahead and hop right into the value. Alright, so just some major takeaways before I really get into the video and things that you really need to remember as you're building your dropshipping store. Now, number one is don't look like a dropshipping store, because as dropshipping gets more and more popular, many people don't have positive experiences with dropshipping stores. So if they see another store that looks like something that they bought from before and didn't have a good experience with, then you're automatically just going to be looked at badly. So just really try to focus on building a brand. Even if you are starting a general store, you can still brand it the right way so that it looks trustworthy and not like all of these other dropshipping sites. Another major takeaway you should get from this video is to get quicker fulfillment as soon as you can. This ties into what I was saying about building a brand, but this is a huge mistake that I made, and you really just flat out cannot build a brand off AliExpress 20 to 30 day shipping. It's just not gonna work. So I'm gonna talk about some different ways that you can get quicker fulfillment later on in this video. But if you are trying to build a brand, which I would really recommend because that's how you dropship the right way in 2020, then you just gotta get quicker fulfillment. All right, so another major takeaway you should get from this video is to build a customer base from one winning product. And from there, you're gonna be able to expand to a whole niche of winning products. And trust me, there are a lot of winning products in almost every single niche out there. So once you find a winner, it's going to be so much easier to get 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different winners. All right, so the last major key that you should get from this video, and probably the most important, is to be innovative and set yourself apart from your competition. Gone are the days that you can just steal someone's Facebook ad, run it with like really super basic targeting or an Instagram influencer, and just, you know, don't really try, because it's not gonna work anymore. You actually have to put some thought and some effort into your advertisements, your store, really everything. It's just not as easy anymore. And that's why it's so rewarding to the people that actually innovate and set themselves apart. The people that brand quickly and that innovate are the ones that are going to be able to dominate a certain product or a certain niche. All right, so step one of launching your amazing new dropshipping store is making a general store. Now, everyone says general stores don't work. They kind of work, they're not the best, but it's really the best you have when you're first starting out. Now, just make sure it doesn't look like crap and you should still be able to get plenty of sales. So I would recommend that you learn how to do product research and then you find 5, preferably at least 10 winning products. Now, obviously you don't know if they're winning yet, but just learn how to find products that have potential and that are already selling pretty well, but aren't super saturated, and then import those to your store using like Oberlo or DSers or any app like that. Just import them from AliExpress. All right, so the next thing that you're gonna wanna do is learn how to advertise. Now, I would either use Facebook ads or Instagram influencers, depending on your budget, really. Instagram is a little bit more budget friendly, but one of the biggest things is you can't just like launch one ad and one ad copy and a couple different interests and like expect it to do something. You really have to test a lot, like test different ads, test different ad copies, test a whole bunch of stuff. And really you should expect to spend at least $200 testing each product. Now, once you find a product that has potential, you're gonna be able to move on to step two. Now, seeing potential in a product is gonna be pretty easy because you're gonna lose money on almost every single product that you test. However, there's gonna be one or two products that you are going to be profitable with if you're doing it the right way. And those are the products that you need to hold on to and move to the product advancement phase. All right, so with product advancement, you really need to test a ton. I know we just came from a testing phase, but really the way you scale a product is you learn what works best. And what works best is going to allow you to take it to the next level. When you just test like two ads and two ad copies and, you know, like 20 different interests, whatever you're doing, you're just not gonna know what works best. So that's why I recommend testing just as much as you possibly can and as many things as you possibly can. Look at all the things I recommend that you test and then do more. So at this point, you should probably focus your general store around that product, because if you do have a potential winner, then that should really be the main focus of attention for you and for your customers. You don't want customers to come on your store and see like all these random products, because at that point you're gonna look like a dropshipping store. Another big part of getting ready to scale is increasing the value of the product. That means testing different prices, and it can also mean adding stuff like retargeting, post-purchase emails, upsells and downsells, and apps that like have quantity breaks. So for example, if you buy two products and you get 10% off, if you buy three products, you get 15% off. A lot of you probably know what I'm talking about, but those are really, really good for low ticket products. Another part of product advancement is decreasing your product cost, and really just your cost in general. So I recommend that you negotiate with your AliExpress suppliers, and I also recommend that if you are using Instagram influencers, then you get bulk pricing set up. What that means is if you have an influencer that's doing really well, really consistently for you, then buy like 5 or 6 or 7 posts. That way you're gonna be able to get a cheaper price and a higher return on ad spend. Now, once your product is doing about $5,000 a month in revenue and you really know it's a winner, then it's time to move on to step 3. So step 3 is store advancement, and that really means that you actually need to focus on that product more so than we were doing in step 2. So this means completely rebranding your general store to the niche store that your product is in. And even if your product is like a super, super general product, for example, a lamp, there's a lamp right there, then you're gonna be able to build a store around like lights or just something that really relates to your product. It doesn't have to be like super specific, but it will really help you if it is. Another part of this is testing to find how your store performs best. So this means testing a couple different themes, different colors, different site layouts, just stuff like that that you haven't tested before. So this is where you really need to start getting serious about customer service and your brand image. For me, I don't really care like too much about customer service when I just have a general store, because I'm not trying to scale that to the moon. But when I have a branded store, then you really, really have to care a lot more about your customers. And that means giving more refunds, accepting returns, figuring out stuff like that so that people like you and they recommend your company. Now, another part of store advancement is adding more niche products, because like I said, you're building a niche store and you really don't want there just to be a couple products in it. So I recommend adding at least 10 different products. You don't really have to advertise those products, but at least have them on your store so that you appear as more of a niche store and people will buy them. I promise you that. All right, so another thing that you need to do when you're really branding your store is to set up good email sequences. Basically, this just means that if a customer does a certain thing, like abandons their cart or purchases a product from you or something like that, then they're gonna get a list of emails. They're gonna get like one an hour after, one 6 hours after, and one a day after, just an example for you. And those are sent automatically. So really the only work that you need to do is to set them up, which takes a couple of hours, but it's well worth it because they just go and they send to everyone. So you're really just getting them free money. All right, so once you're selling at least about 200 products a month, or maybe doing about $10,000 in revenue, then it's probably time to switch to an agent. This is one of the ways that you can get faster shipping, and it's also a way to get cheaper product prices. Most agents have an order minimum of like 200 to 250 orders, but they may be able to be more lenient if it's a higher ticket product. All right, so the next step is brand advancement. This is really where you turn up like big time on your branding. This includes stuff like private labeling your product and wholesaling it from Alibaba so that you have US inventory. I do have a US warehouse right now, and you're welcome to DM me on Instagram if you would like my contact. So another part of brand advancement is getting your own ads made, because you really can't just expect to steal people's ads forever and expect there to be no consequences. This also allows you to be innovative and be different and separate yourself from your competitors. Make sure that you watermark these ads properly so that no one else can steal them. One really good way to get ads made is to send your product to people on Fiverr. A lot of these people will send you clips of them using the product so that you can use those to make ads with it. Another way to get your own ads made is to send your product to influencers. This could be people on like YouTube or Instagram or whatever, and have them record a video of them using the product. Now you can also do this as a type of advertisement, which I would honestly really recommend, because getting a personalized recommendation for a company is a lot better than just a cold advertisement to an uninterested audience. Alright, so the last step is brand exploitation. Now, really the only like thing that you have to do is step one, and that is using your winners data to advertise other niche winners. Now, this is really, 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 really important, because if you sell a store and 99% of your sales come from one product, then it's really, really going to decrease the value of your store. But since you already have the data from your one winning product, then you can move on to a bunch of other products in that niche and really sell them way easier than you would be able to without it. This is also part of diversifying your income, because if really bad things start to go on with that product, which does happen, then you're going to be able to have other things that can support you and support your store. All right, so the next steps that I'm going to be talking about are really optional, but they set you up to be in a really good position if you do decide to sell your store. One of these is signing up to be an Amazon seller. This may sound kind of productive because Shopify stores are big competitors of Amazon, but it's going to look really good to a potential investor if you have diversified sales channels. It's also going to really, really boost your sales, because Amazon gets just an incredible amount of orders. Another thing that you can do is try to get your product in department stores. Now, this may sound really unrealistic, but there was a dropshipping store for the burrito blanket a couple months ago that did manage to get their product in Macy's. And if you can get your product in a big department store, then obviously it just looks incredible and really helps boost your brand. Another super important thing that I guess is optional is trying to get trademarks or patents on your products or your brand. Now, it may be a bit of a stretch to get it on your products, considering there's probably dozens of other stores selling the same thing. But if you get your logo and your brand name and all that just trademarked so that no one else can steal it, then it does help when you go to sell your store. Alright, so when you go to sell your store, make sure that you sell it before your sales drop. If you've been running your store for a long time, then you're probably going to have a good feeling of the market, and you're going to know once your sales are going to decrease. You definitely don't want to sell your store at a low point, because then you're not going to be able to get near as much money for it as you could. Another thing that you can do is sell your data. Believe it or not, tons of other people in e-commerce, just like you and me, sell their data. Now, this is kind of controversial, but you can sell it to other advertisers so that they're able to target the same audience, which is really powerful if you do have a ton of customers. Now, obviously, you don't want people targeting your customer base if you're still like advertising. So I would either do that after you sell your store or just stop advertising in general. Alright guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Hopefully you were able to get a ton of value out of it, and hopefully I was really able to simplify the process of dropshipping. Now, being successful at dropshipping is not easy, but it is simple. Be sure to hit that big red subscribe button on your way out, and I'll see you in the next one.